Once upon a time, in a tiny apartment just outside of a very big city, there lived a princess and her two dogs who were trying to adjust during a worldwide pandemic. But would she be able to survive the quarantine? This is her story. Okay, stop. Pause for a second. Jeez. Oh, I am already exhausted. The princess certainly seemed to be adapting well with her many hobbies. I'm gonna fast forward here. As the days of isolation turned into weeks, she started to turn into a bit of a germaphobe. Understandable, of course, under these circumstances. But it became... well, you'll see.
Trill a cheery tune in the tub as you scrub the stubborn mildew stain. Pull like a hairball from the shower drain to that gay refrain of a happy working song. We'll keep singing without fail, otherwise we'd spoil it. Hosing down the garbage pail and scrubbing up the toilet. Oh! Wanna know a secret? Promise not to tell. We are standing by a wishing well. Make a wish into the well. That's all you have to do. And if you hear it echoing, your wish will soon come true.
I wish COVID-19 would disappear.
Let me cut in here and save her the humiliation of singing Oz into a toilet. I mean, wishing well. Let's fast forward. Show off. Anyway, all of that singing took it out of her, and she had a revelation.
I think I may be going slightly insane.
You can say that again.
Hey, Mr. Narrator Man! That's not fair! But you are right. I do need to snap out of my cleaning bliss and venture out. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Let's do this.
And so... like any true Disney heroine, she knew she had to face her fears and these unprecedented times head on. She didn't know what she might face, but she felt ready. She decided to drive immediately to her favorite Starbucks, but it was closed. So, she did what any princess would do in this situation. She dreamed about the day she would be reunited with her beloved iced skinny caramel macchiato with an extra shot of espresso.
A dream is a wish your heart makes. When you're fast asleep,
the magic of dreaming. She drove to more of her favorite places by way of her chariot, but had many moments of frustration and aggression in seeing that they were all closed. As more time passed, our quarantined princess started to feel a wave of sadness kick in.
she couldn't help but think about all that she was missing out on. One afternoon, she was feeling particularly down.
I want to be where the people are. I want to see them dancing.
Just then, a call on her phone. It was her family, from her kingdom. They talked for hours as she heard the devastating news that some of her relatives were sick from the virus. This truly affected the princess and put everything into perspective for her.
How could I have been so self-absorbed, dreaming of my prince when my own family is going through so much. For the first time in forever, I finally understand. For the first time in forever, we can fix this hand in hand.
Don't worry, not literally. There will be gloves.
We can head down this mountain together. We don't have to live in fear. Cause for the first time in forever, I will be right here.
Metaphorically speaking.
She started waking up every day with a new meaning, with a grateful heart, with a purpose to check in on those she loved, even though it had to be a Zoom call.
Hey, Belle.
The princess pondered her purpose. She realized she still had so much to give to others during this time of uncertainty. She got creative with ways to help those in her community who are suffering by teaching princess lessons online. Streaming guitar concerts to her kingdom. Taking painting requests. And baking for her neighbors. All those hobbies from the beginning of our story really paid off. She began fully appreciating all of the little things life has to offer, and not taking one day of her life for granted.
Oh, my sweet dog. I don't need princess popularity, or a crown, or a prince, or a fairy godmother, or any old dragon to slay. Everything I need is right here. Let's dance!
The